dog. Sure, just pick another color.
But it's my wedding.
You heard the Muppet. Pick or we will.
Okay, try on the gold dresses. It really doesn't matter what you two will be wearing. Everyone's gonna be looking at me.
No, we should just design our own bridesmaids' dresses. I mean, Shelly designed her gown. Next to her, we're gonna look so frumpy.
Girl, this is nothing. You should have seen the dresses when my cousin Chardonnay got married.
Hey, Chardonnay?
Don't get me started. Black people and their creative names. It makes me crazy.
Well, I've got a nephew named Chewbacca.
White people do it, too.
And an aunt named Mayonnaise.
Mayonnaise? Hey, I should introduce her to my Uncle Dijon.
Yeah, I wonder who Shelly's gonna ask to be her maid of honor. Because I'd love to do it.
I should be her maid of honor.
Why you?
Because I'm her oldest friend.
Janie, how do I say this nicely? You take ugly pictures.
What? Yeah, you do. You know, your face gets all scrunchy and you get those little beady red eyes. I mean, Shelly doesn't want a zombie in her wedding pictures.
Oh, she wants Skeletor.
Zombie.
Skeletor.
Zombie.
Ooh. Boy.
You look so beautiful.
I know. Now, quick, open the window before I sweat out my pits.
Okay, I'll do it.
Let me take a look at you. Turn around.
Hey, Shells, you didn't mention your mama's coming to visit.
She's not. She's home in Philly.
Oh. Well, there's a woman who looks just like your mother getting out of a cab out front.
You know, Rita, we don't all look alike. Or maybe we do. Shelly, that is your mom.
Oh, my God, what is she doing here? Quick, change, hide all this stuff. What?
Why are we hiding everything?
Because I don't want her to know I'm getting married. Now go.
Please just tell me what's going on.
Oh, sure, Rita. We could sit and chat over a nice hot cup of tea, or you could just freaking help me.
What's on?
My zipper's stuck.
Okay, well, wait.
Coming.
I'll cover. Oh, Land of Goshen. Having trouble with the locks.
Land of Goshen? Shh, I'm in character.
Jump at your husband. What's wrong with this thing?
You know what? This zipper is really stuck. If we are not careful, it'll rip. Oh! Like that!
Hey, baby!
Mommy!
Did I surprise you?
I'm so surprised I jumped right out of my clothes.
Who likes to look fly? Can pick up any guy with a slick rap line. Give him the eye, get the keys to the ride, and live the single life, little teasing on the side. She's the type of chick who like to wear fly clothes. It rocks the lead toes, but we'll get ghetto. If anybody knows, I'ma tell you who knows. Who's spinning the cash flow, let the story be told. EVE.
How you do that?
EVE.
How you do that?
EVE.
How you do that?
Well, I'm glad you're excited. I started to call.
That would have been good.
But I thought, what the heck? I'll just surprise her.
And you did!
Have you gained weight?
No, actually, I've lost some.
Mm-hmm. She's built like her father's side of the family. Flat chest and ass for days.
Well, it's true.
Luckily, you take after me in the face. You know, those Williams girls are some mannish-looking women.
Is that any relation to Venus and Serena? Because they are absolutely stunning.
Mom, why don't you go freshen up and I'll take you out to dinner?
Oh, that sounds good. I am looking forward to spending some time with you.
Me too. I've missed you so much. I can't wait to catch up with you. What in the name of Terry McMillan have I done to earn such bad karma?
Shelly, why haven't you told your mother you're engaged to JT?
Well, ever since my parents divorced, my mother is totally anti-marriage. She'll have a fit when she finds out I'm getting married so young.
Yeah, I remember when I married Marty right out of high school. Your mom didn't want us to be friends anymore. Said I was a bad influence. Meanwhile, the real bad seed was in the boiler room smoking weed.
That is a lie. It was the janitor's closet.
Shelly, you're getting married. You can't hide this from your mom forever. When are you gonna tell her?
She'll get an invitation. If I tell her any sooner, she'll ruin everything.
Oh, at stressful times like this, it's important that we pray.
Dear Lord, please help Shelly through this difficult situation.
Also, let her have a forgiving spirit when she finds out that I've already told her mother she's getting married.
Maybe you should pray silently next time.
I'm sorry. It's been a whole month, and I didn't know it was supposed to be a secret.
I told you not to tell anyone.
But you didn't say secret. If it's a secret, you have to say secret. Those are the rules. I didn't make them up.
Well, I'm officially out of options to keep me in the country. I am not eligible for the green card lottery or political asylum, and no one will marry me.
By the way, I was very moved by your proposal. But you do understand that Massachusetts is way too cold for black people.
Yeah. Hey, Nick, listen, I really appreciate you and JT letting me crash here. At this point, all my savings are gone. Can't even afford the ticket back to England.
That's okay. Uncle Sam will deport you for free.
What's up, fellas?
Hey.
Yo, Nick, I got your mail.
This is yours. It's from Miami State Medical School.
Oh, thanks.
JT, about the letter? Just anything you want to tell us?
Nope.
He obviously doesn't want to talk about it, but it's some kind of medical document.
I'm betting it's more plastic surgery. He thinks we didn't notice the new nose.
Okay. A few months ago, I applied to med school.
Notice he didn't deny the nose, Jack.
Hey, that's really impressive, man. Why didn't you tell anyone?
Well, I've been thinking about going for a while, but there's nothing to tell if I don't get in.
Well, let's see if you did. Open the letter. Don't be scared.
Yes, I made it. I'm in.
Yeah, congratulations.
Hey, you're on a roll. First you get engaged, and now this. In a minute, you're gonna be an adult.
Never.
Hey, seriously, though, JT, I mean, getting married and going back to school at the same time, that could be tough. They're both big commitments.
You got that right. The school loan's gonna cost me at least 30 grand a year.
And you know your bride-to-be likes the bling.
Compliments of the gentleman at the corner table.
My, well, tell him I said thank you.
Actually, he sent it to her.
Oh, tell him thank you, but I don't do domestic champagne. So, you've caught up on me. Anything new with you?
Well, actually, not much to tell. Gloria Stefan is now a client. I'm getting married. Oh, and I switched from a roll-on deodorant to an invisible solid. No more white streaks.
Did you say married? No, this is such a shock. I had no idea.
Mom, I know Janie already told you.
Well, then why didn't you tell me?
I didn't want to miss the look on your face when you heard, so I was going to fly to Philly, but now you're here, so guess what? I'm getting married. Surprise! That's not the look I was hoping for. Mom, I'm sorry. I guess I was just scared to tell you.
Honey, you can tell me anything. I'll always be here for you. Even now, when you're making the biggest mistake of your life, I'll be right by your side.
I knew you'd do this.
What? Try to talk sense into you?
You're trying to ruin my happiness.
Is everything okay here?
Oh, yes, the trout was wonderful.
My compliments to the chef. Look, I am offering you the benefit of wisdom gained through experience. I've had both a marriage and an episiotomy, and trust me, the episiotomy was more fun.
For the last time, I'm sorry I had such a big head.
Oh, I don't blame you for that, honey. I blame your big-headed daddy.
Why don't you just admit it? You don't like JT.
I like JT, but this is not about him. This is about you and your life.
That's right. It's my life, and I'm the only one who can live it. I'm getting married. I love JT, and he loves me.
Oh, I don't doubt that you're in love. You're always in love.
But this time is forever.
I should have known you'd do something like this. Remember how you embarrassed me at career day?
I was six. It was cute.
All the other little girls wanted to be dancers or astronauts. But what did my child want to be when she grew up? Married.
I was six. It was cute.
Maybe then, but not anymore. You had your first boyfriend in nursery school, and you haven't been alone since. You've always been Shelley and some guy.
I was popular. At least I wasn't smoking weed like Janie.
Oh, please. Janie gave you up at graduation. And stop trying to change the subject. You've always defined yourself in terms of being part of a couple. When are you going to take the time to figure out who you are independent of a man?
I know who I am. Shelley Williams, soon to be Dr. Hunter's wife. Ha! Didn't know he was going to be a doctor, did you?
Listen to me. You'll never know how amazing you are if you don't learn how to be just Shelley. You are not ready to get married.
Yes, I am.
No, you are not.
Mom, you need to butt out.
What did you say?
You need to butter your bread. Buttery.
Here's another pillow.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Hey, and thanks again for letting me hide out here. This is just like the Underground Railroad.
This is nothing like that.
And your Uncle Tom keeping me safe?
Uncle Tom?
Was it Uncle Ben?
Where are you getting this misinformation?
From the bald guy at the 7-Eleven.
You mean the skinhead?
I thought he was a cancer patient. But I know my staying here is a big deal, and if I get caught, you could lose your government job.
You were just supposed to be gone a week ago, man. I mean, nobody's looking for you yet. Besides, man, we're boys. Got your back, man. You're going down.
What the fuck?
And you're going down alone.
Wait, go on.
I'm looking for Donovan Brink.
I haven't seen him.
I don't understand. Does Donovan live here?
He's holding me hostage. Go get help. Hi, Imogen. Nick, this is an old friend of mine. She is definitely not with the INS.
Oh, God, hardly.
Ah, cool. Whew, that was close, buddy. But you know, we're in this together.
Oh, it's so good to see you. You look wonderful.
Oh, thanks. You don't.
Well, being a fugitive has affected my sleep.
Yes, well, actually, that's why I've come to see you. I think I have a solution to your immigration problem.
Really? That's great!
You've heard of Harrison Jeffers?
Yeah, that huge British conglomerate that has companies around the world. They were linked to that nasty arms scandal in the Middle East. Corporate scum.
I work for them now.
Well, it's two sides to every story.
Yes, well, I'm able to live in Miami because the company provides me with a work visa. And if you like, I'm pretty sure I'll be able to get you a job there too.
Really? Oh, I'm thrilled!
It's a sales position.
Oh, sales.
Yes, well, nothing's lovelier than a sunny day in London.
Oh, no, I'll take the job. I'm a born salesman. I love to sell. I can sell anything. Are you buying this?
No.
Thanks for the tea.
You're welcome. And you're wrong.
Did you say something?
Just good night.
Night.
Don't know what she's talking about. I'm not always in a relationship. I have my own identity.
Do you want to go with me?
Yes.
Shelly and Miles forever.
Shelly and Malik ever.
I want to break up.
I'm Jimmy.
Shelly and Jimmy forever.
This is how we do it.
Shelly and Killa forever. Shelly and Steve forever.
Would you like to dance?
Shelly and JT forever.
Thank you.
You know, kind of boring. But it's just something to keep me in the country legally. I'll find another job soon.
What are you selling? I'll buy something from you if it's under 1995.
No, I don't think I'd have anything that'd interest you.
So what's in the pretty blue case?
Nothing. Put it back.
Let me see.
Wait, don't.
Oh, it's full of makeup.
Hot lips. Please tell me you jacked the Avon Lay.
Well, this is what I'm selling. I'm a Bethany Blue makeup consultant.
I think that's wonderful.
My boy sells feminine products.
Oh, stop laughing at him. It's an honest living.
Hey, babe.
Hey. Thanks for meeting me.
It's no problem.
I missed you.
Yeah, I've been caught up with my mother.
My mother wants to have you guys over for dinner so we can all get to know each other and be one big happy family. How's that sound?
Like the seventh level of hell, but...
Yeah, well, welcome to marriage and in-laws, huh?
Actually, that's what I wanted to talk to you about.
What? What is it?
I don't know. Nothing. Never mind.
No. Obviously, something's bothering you, so come on. Talk to me.
Well, I just sort of realized that I've been so excited about getting married that I hadn't really thought about whether I'm ready to be married.
What, so now you don't want to get married?
I do. Just not yet. I need some time.
Time for what?
Well, I'm always claiming to be such an independent woman, but the truth is I'm not because I'm always in a relationship. Before I get married, I need to know that I can stand on my own two feet.
Wow.
JT, I'm so sorry. The last thing I would ever do is hurt you.
Oh, I know that. And I gotta confess, I mean, this isn't the best time for me to be getting married either. I mean, med school, it's a big commitment. I wasn't sure we could even afford a wedding.
What? No. I'm having a fabulous wedding. Horse-drawn carriage, white doves, James Ingram.
James Ingram?
Yeah, he's available, I checked.
Okay, well, back to us not getting married. Where exactly does that leave us?
With me hoping that I'm not making the biggest mistake of my life.
Well, we can still be together, can't we?
No. I can't be in any kind of relationship right now. It can't be Shelly and JT. It's gotta be just Shelly.
Oh. Oh, okay. So what you're saying is it's over.
No. Well, yeah. I guess it is. For now. We'll always be friends.
Of course you will.
JT.
Yeah.
Maybe someday.
Yeah. Maybe.
Ready to return all this stuff?
Yeah.
I am so happy that you listened to me and called off the wedding.
Mom, you had nothing to do with me changing my mind. I am a grown woman. I make my own decisions.
Of course you do. Are you gonna wear those shoes?
Oh, no, I hate these.
Yeah, well, welcome to marriage and in-laws, huh?
Actually, that's what I wanted to talk to you about.
What? What is it?
I don't know. Nothing. Never mind.
No. Obviously, something's bothering you, so come on. Talk to me.
Well, I just sort of realized that I've been so excited about getting married that I hadn't really thought about whether I'm ready to be married.
What, so now you don't want to get married?
I do. Just not yet. I need some time.
Time for what?
Well, I'm always claiming to be such an independent woman, but the truth is I'm not because I'm always in a relationship. Before I get married, I need to know that I can stand on my own 2 feet.
Wow.
JT, I'm so sorry. The last thing I would ever do is hurt you.
Oh, I know that. And I gotta confess, I mean, this isn't the best time for me to be getting married either. I mean, med school, it's a big commitment. I wasn't sure we could even afford a wedding.
What? No. I'm having a fabulous wedding. Horse-drawn carriage, white doves, James Ingram.
James Ingram?
Yeah, he's available, I checked.
Okay, well, back to us not getting married. Where exactly does that leave us?
With me hoping that I'm not making the biggest mistake of my life.
Well, we can still be together, can't we?
No. I can't be in any kind of relationship right now. It can't be Shelly and JT. It's gotta be just Shelly.
Oh. Oh, okay. So what you're saying is it's over.
No. Well, yeah. I guess it is. For now. We'll always be friends.
Of course you will.
Hey, how was your first day at work?
Kind of boring. But it's just something to keep me in the country legally. I'll find another job soon.
What are you selling? I'll buy something from you if it's under 1995.
I don't think I'd have anything that'd interest you.
So what's in the pretty blue case?
Nothing. Put it back.
Let me see.
Wait, don't.
Oh, it's full of makeup.
Hot lips. Please tell me you jacked the Avon Lay.
Well, this is what I'm selling. I'm a Bethany Blue makeup consultant.
Hey, babe.
Hey. Thanks for meeting me.
It's no problem.
I missed you.
Yeah, I've been caught up with my mother.
My mother wants to have you guys over for dinner so we can all get to know each other and be one big happy family. How's that sound?
Like the 7th level of hell, but...
Yeah, well, welcome to marriage and in-laws, huh?
Actually, that's what I wanted to talk to you about.
What? What is it?
I don't know. Nothing. Never mind.
No. Obviously, something's bothering you, so come on. Talk to me.
Well, just sort of realized that I've been so excited about getting married that I hadn't really thought about whether I'm ready to be married.
What, so now you don't want to get married?
I do. Just not yet. I need some time.
Time for what?
Well, I'm always claiming to be such an independent woman, but the truth is I'm not because I'm always in a relationship. Before I get married, I need to know that I can stand on my own 2 feet.
Wow.
JT, I'm so sorry. The last thing I would ever do is hurt you.
Oh, I know that. And I gotta confess, I mean, this isn't the best time for me to be getting married either. I mean, med school, it's a big commitment. I wasn't sure we could even afford a wedding.
What? I'm sorry. I guess I was just scared to tell you.
Honey, you can tell me anything. I'll always be here for you. Even now, when you're making the biggest mistake of your life, I'll be right by your side.
I knew you'd do this.
What? Try to talk sense into you?
You're trying to ruin my happiness.
Is everything okay here?
Oh, yes, the trout was wonderful.
My compliments to the chef. Look, I am offering you the benefit of wisdom gained through experience. I've had both a marriage and an episiotomy, and trust me, the episiotomy was more fun.
For the last time, I'm sorry I had such a big head.
Oh, I don't blame you for that, honey. I blame your big-headed daddy.
Why don't you just admit it? You don't like JT.
I like JT, but this is not about him. This is about you and your life.
That's right. It's my life, and I'm the only one who can live it. I'm getting married. I love JT, and he loves me.
Oh, I don't doubt that you're in love. You're always in love.
But this time is forever.
I should have known you'd do something like this. Remember how you embarrassed me at career day?
I was 6. It was cute.
All the other little girls wanted to be dancers or astronauts. But what did my child want to be when she grew up? Married.
I was 6. It was cute.
Maybe then, but not anymore. You had your first boyfriend in nursery school, and you haven't been alone since. You've always been Shelley and some guy.
I was popular. At least I wasn't smoking weed like Janie.
Oh, please. Janie gave you up at graduation. And stop trying to change the subject. You've always defined yourself in terms of being part of a couple. When are you going to take the time to figure out who you are independent of a man?
I know who I am. Shelley Williams, soon to be Dr. Hunter's wife. Ha! Didn't know he was going to be a doctor, did you?
Listen to me. You'll never know how amazing you are if you don't learn how to be just Shelley. You are not ready to get married.
Yes, I am.
No, you are not.
Mom, you need to butt out.
What did you say?
You need to butter your bread. Buttery.
Here's another pillow.
Oh, thanks, buddy. Hey, and thanks again for letting me hide out here. This is just like the Underground Railroad.
This is nothing like that.
And your Uncle Tom keeping me safe?
Uncle Tom?
Was it Uncle Ben?
Where are you getting this misinformation?
From the bald guy at the 7-Eleven.
You mean the skinhead?
I thought he was a cancer patient. But I know my staying here.
Oh. Now, quick, open the window before I sweat out my pits.
Okay, let me take a look at you. Turn around.
Hey, Shells, you didn't mention your mama's coming to visit.
She's not. She's home in Philly.
Oh. Well, there's a woman who looks just like your mother getting out of a cab out front.
You know, Rita, we don't all look alike. Or maybe we do. Shelley, that is your mom.
Oh, my God, what is she doing here? Quick change, hide all this stuff. What?
Why are we hiding everything?
Because I don't want her to know I'm getting married. Now go.
Please just tell me what's going on.
Oh, sure, Rita. We could sit and chat over a nice hot cup of tea, or you could just freaking help me.
What's on?
My zipper's stuck.
Okay, well, wait.
Coming.
I'll cover. Oh, land of Goshen. Trouble with the locks.
land of Goshen. Shh, I'm in character.
Jump at your husband. What's wrong with this thing?
You know what? This zipper is really stuck. If we are not careful, it'll rip.
Oh!
Like that.
Did I surprise you?
I'm so surprised I jumped right out of my clothes.
She's the kind of chick who likes to look fly. Can pick up any guy with a slick rap line. Give him the eye, get the keys to the ride, and live the single life, little teasing on the side. She's the type of chick who like to wear fly clothes. It rocks the lead toes, but we'll get ghetto. If anybody knows, I'ma tell you who knows. Who's spinning the cash flow, let the story be told. Come on. EVE.
How you do that?
EVE.
How you do that?
Well, I'm glad you're excited. I started to call.
That would have been good.
But I thought, what the heck? I'll just surprise her.
And you did.
Have you gained weight?
No, actually, I've lost some.
Mm-hmm. She's built like her father's side of the family. Flat chest and ass for days.
Well, it's true.
Luckily, you take after me in the face. You know, those Williams girls are some mannish-looking women.
To Venus and Serena, because they are absolutely stunning.
Mom, why don't you go freshen up and I'll take you out to dinner?
Oh, that sounds good. I am looking forward to spending some time with you.
Me too. I've missed you so much. I can't wait to catch up with you. What in the name of Terry McMillan have I done to earn such bad karma?
Shelley, why haven't you told your mother you're engaged to JT?
Well, ever since my parents...
B likes the bling.
Compliments of the gentleman at the corner table.
My, well, tell him I said thank you.
Actually, he sent it to her.
Oh, tell him thank you, but I don't do domestic champagne. So, you've caught up on me. Anything new with you?
Well, actually, not much to tell. Gloria Stefan is now a client. I'm getting married. Oh, and I switched from a roll-on deodorant to an invisible solid. No more white streaks.
Did you say married? No, this is such a shock. I had no idea.
Mom, I know Jamie already told you.
Well, then why didn't you tell me?
I didn't want to miss the look on your face when you heard, so I was gonna fly to Philly, but now you're here, so guess what? I'm getting married. Surprise! That's not the look I was hoping for. Mom, I'm sorry. I guess I was just scared to tell you.
Honey, you can tell me anything. I'll always be here for you. Even now, when you're making the biggest mistake of your life, I'll be right by your side.
I knew you'd do this.
What? Try to talk sense into you?
You're trying to ruin my happiness.
Is everything okay here?
Oh, yes, the trout was wonderful.
My compliments to the chef. Look, I am offering you the benefit of wisdom gained through experience. I've had both a marriage and an episiotomy, and trust me, the episiotomy was more fun.
For the last time, I'm sorry I had such a big head.
Oh, I don't blame you for that, honey. I blame your big-headed daddy.
Why don't you just admit it? You don't like JT.
I like JT, but this is not about him. This is about you and your life.
That's right. It's my life, and I'm the only one who can live it. I'm getting married. I love JT, and he loves me.
Oh, I don't doubt that you're in love. You're always in love.
But this time is forever.
I should have known you'd do something like this. Remember how you embarrassed me at career day?
I was six. It was cute.
All the other little girls wanted to be dancers or astronauts. But what did my child want to be when she grew up? Married.
I was six. It was cute.
Maybe then, but not anymore. You had your first boyfriend in nursery school, and you haven't been alone since. You've always been Shelley and some guy.
I was popular. At least I wasn't smoking weed like Janie.
Oh, please. Janie gave you up at graduation. And stop trying to change the subject. You've always defined yourself in terms of being part of a couple. When are you going to take the time to figure out who you are independent of a man?
I know who I am. Shelley Williams, soon to be Dr. Hunter's wife. Ha! Didn't know he was.